Airman Cave Archives! Knowing and doing are two different things.
Hey, welcome back to Airman Cave Archives. Alright, so, to continue on with the recruiter stories, I would say that honesty is your best policy. A, because it's going to prevent you from going to jail at some point, potentially. But it's also going to keep you from being stressed. And so I had told you a story about an individual that lied to me about their illegal drug use. Things come back to bite you, man. Karma is way, way mean. And you don't want to have that weighing on you so that you have to look over your shoulder all the time while you're in the service. So do yourself a favor and be honest with your recruiter. There's a waiver process for a reason. Yeah, you might be disqualified for some of the jobs that you might be interested in. But later on, say you go to apply for a position that requires a polygraph test. And so they start asking you questions and you're forced to lie. And by doing so, you could do more damage to your career if you would have just started off on the right foot by being honest. Recruiters have heard it all. And so if you try and sugarcoat something or you try to beat around the bush, they're typically going to be able to pick up on that, especially if they're seasoned. So, you know, and then you get under the spotlight of MEPS or the Military Entrance Processing Station. You get under the spotlight of basic training and, yeah, it just doesn't end well for you if you're not honest. Now, keep in mind, if you withhold information, I had seen many times where a recruiter friend of mine was stressed out because they get a call from the recruiter police, and we talked about that in a previous episode. And there's an applicant that's now down at basic training trying to say that, you know, the recruiter had told them to say something or not say something, and knowing that that's a lie. And so now basically they've gotten down into the pressures of going through basic training. They don't want to be there, and so they make up a story and they try and screw over the recruiter and get themselves out of basic training and go home. Buck up and handle basic training, you know, get through it, but at the same time, don't try and burn any bridges and say things that aren't true. So again, be honest up front, and if you can't handle basic, be honest why you're home. It's typically not because the Air Force has booted you. It's because something's come up that you may have not been honest about in the first place, or you just couldn't handle it and you had to go home. Thanks for stopping by, and we'll see you next time.
Airman Cave Archives! Knowing and doing are two different things.